This PLC learning video, we will see architecture and wiring of PLC. As you can see, its architecture. In the CPU is communicating with the remote, input output module, digital input output module, backplane, power supply, printer, programmer unit, MMI, memory, analog input output module, function modules, communication processor, and the end user. So this is the main architecture of the PLC. We will see the CPU. A processor or central processing unit is a unit that contains a microprocessor that processes input signals and controls according to the program stored in memory, then communicate the decisions it takes as control signal to the output interface. So the processor takes input, process it as per our program, and then gives the output. The CPU function is to manage all the processes that occurs in the PLC. There are three main components that makes up this CPU, namely the processor, memory, and the power supply. So these are the three main components. Input output module. In general, data information on PLC is expressed in the form of electrical voltage between 5 to 15 volt DC, while the outside voltage system varies between 24 to 240 volt DC and AC. Input output units is intended for interfacing between these two quantities. So this is the interface. The input module has several functions, including detects when a signal is received from the sensor, converts the input signal into a voltage level that can be received by the processor, sending a signal to the PLC input indicator so that it can know which input is receiving the signal. So this is the function of input module, that it detects input, converts it, and then send it to the PLC. The output module has several functions, including the output unit in the PLC also function as interface to external equipment. The PLC output act as a switch to the power supply to operate the output equipment, relay, solenoid valve. So the PLC will operate the relay, and then after that relay we can take supply to the SUV or anything we want. Components commonly used by PLC as output units are relays for AC-DC, trig for AC only, and transistor or FETs for DC only. PLC data and memory. Like computer system, PLC memory consists of RAM and ROM. The memory capacity between one PLC and another varies depending on the type and the manufacturer. Some factories state the size of memory in bytes. There are also kilobytes, and some are expressed by the number of instructions that can be stored. So the memory can be in the bytes, kilobytes, or in the number of instructions that memory can store. Power supply, the voltage source needed by the PLC, memory, and other circuits in PLC. And this power supply is a DC voltage source, generally for digital components. A direct voltage of 5 volt is required. So most of the time the power supply is 5 volt DC. Programming unit. Programming unit provides printed suggestion so that user can communicate with programmable control circuit. This allows the user to enter, edit, and monitor the program by connecting to the processor unit and allowing access to the user's memory. So programming unit is a communicator between the PLC and the user. Here you can see the PLC wiring. This is the programmable logic controller PLC. This is CPU. Output is giving output to the equipments, and sensors and other inputs are given by the input module, and then the CPU is communicating with the display. The wiring diagram demonstrates straight hardwired link inputs and output to the PLC. The displayed instruments are on-off or digital in nature, but the PLC signal is analog. As you can see, when we switch S1, S2, S3, then it will be input of the PLC and it will give output Y1 to SOV, Y2, Y3 to the indications. Many frequently used phones comply with the 4 to 20 milliamp standards, whereby 4 milliamps and 20 milliamp signal from the minimum and maximum analog signal values respectively. A separate cable must be run between the end device and the control system with analog devices, because on the circuit only one analog signal can be represented. Slowly replacing the 4 to 20 milliamp standard with the network or field bus communications. Field bus is a two-way digital multi-drop communication connection between smart devices. So for the analog, we have to use a separate cable for the each instrument, but in the field bus communication, we can use a single cable for the signal of different instruments.